Good morning. Last week I got a call from a Ukrainian refugee friend with an 05 Corolla that's making a knocking sound. Let's see if we can diagnose it. Now listen to this. Do you hear that rattling, knocking noise? Last week, with a stethoscope, the noise seemed to be loudest over the water pump, but it's hard to be sure. What do you think's causing it? So if you don't have a stethoscope, here's a DIY option. Cut the bottom off a plastic milk carton and tightly tape the handle of a screwdriver to it. Then you very carefully hold the end of the screwdriver onto various parts of the engine to try and decide where the sound is coming from. Okay, so at that point I removed the serpentine belt and briefly ran the engine to see if the noise was still there, and it was gone. And so that's pretty compelling evidence to say that the noise is coming from one of the belt-driven accessories. The trick is which one. All of the pulleys actually seem to be pretty good. They all spun just fine, which had me scratching my head. So I went back to the water pump and looked at it again, and if I tip the water pump off-axis, just tip it off-axis, there's a slight amount of play there. And so on the strength of that evidence, we're going to remove the water pump today. So there are two ways to take off this water pump. The first and traditional way with these transverse engines is to take off the motor mount. Now, to take off the motor mount, you have to support the engine. So you put a jack under the engine with a block of wood and support the oil pan, take the motor mount off. Now, often it's easier to go in from the side, and so you end up jacking up the vehicle, taking off the right wheel, and coming in through the right wheel fender to get at the bolts. It's possible to do that this way, but I'm going to try and do it a little simpler way without jacking the engine up, by just taking off the alternator first and then trying to sneak the water pump around the motor mount without taking that off. Let's see how that goes. The usual strategy is to do a full coolant flush at the same time. Many professionals prefer to remove a lower radiator hose because the plastic drain petcocks like you see here can leak after you use them. I didn't see a hose that was easy to get to, so I drained from this petcock by rotating a few turns. To drain faster, release the vacuum at the radiator cap. Because we're removing the alternator, the negative connection to the battery needs to be removed. I put a sock on the free end, so even if it springs loose, it can't make contact with the battery. The next step is to take off the serpentine belt. This is a 19 millimeter. This thing has a little tab. Push in, squeeze, and pull. There. Okay, this connection on the alternator might give you some trouble. This is a little push tab, and you squeeze here, and that pulls up this section right here, and there's a little hole there and a hook on the brown connector that hooks in. So you squeeze, wiggle, pull. Push in first so it gets it off. Now the other thing you notice is it looks like there's a little bit of corrosion there, so I'm going to clean that up before we put it back on. Now this last ground connection is a little bit tricky, and I fiddled it for a little while, so I'm going to show you how to do it. Now you get this little L-shaped pick here, and you lift a little tab up that way. You lift it this way, and at the same time you pull it out. So you lift up that tab and then pull. And here's what it looks like. There's that tab there, and that tab fits into this little hole in the bracket. If you can't get it, the bracket is bolted on, so that's an alternate way of doing it, but we got it here without breaking it. Okay, this next bolt is 12 millimeter. I've broken it free. Now the deep one is 14. I've got it on a very short extension. Oh, that sucker's tight. So that's much better view of our water pump. Here's our bolts here. 1, 2, 3, 4. We've got some on the back, so we'll just get those off. I think these are going to all be 10 millimeters. These bolts are of different lengths, so you need to keep track of where they came from. And there was also a modification in the design of these, and so don't be surprised if the bolt lengths that you have to use later are different. I'll draw your attention to this technical service bulletin. The original version of this water pump used 30 millimeter bolts, and a couple of years later they changed the design to require two 20 millimeter bolts at these two red locations. The pump on this vehicle already had the updated short bolts. Here's a tip: when you're putting it back together, put the long bolts in first so you'll get early feedback that a bolt's in the wrong place.
The
got all the bolts free with difficulty. Now I'm just going to pull it out. Didn't require a lot of prying. So some of the early iterations of this pump, I'm not sure if this is an OEM pump, but some of the early iterations had a slightly different thickness here, which meant that you require different bolts if you have different thickness. And so I've carefully measured the thickness of the flange, 12.2, 12.1, and it looks like it matches up pretty well all the way along. Okay, here's a look at the thermostat. It all looks to be normal as far as I can see. Now this is a Scotch-Brite pad. Because it's aluminum, you want to be really careful here. The sealing is done with the O-ring and the adjacent metal, and so you don't need any RTV here. This is just a thin film of silicone paste I'm putting on here for two reasons: to help stick it into place, and secondly, it'll help to seal off any minor leaks. This is completely non-drying, and so it's different than RTV. Okay, so have a look at this. This is a mounting bushing, and it's designed to take up the slack. You see, the alternator sits on this post that's right in here, and the bolt goes through it. There's no threads on this side, and it threads into this thing. And when you tighten this up, it slides this bushing towards the post, so it takes up all the slack. The problem is, when you go to reinsert it, it's really tricky to get it into place, and so you want to somehow tap that bushing back a ways to give yourself more room to make it easier to install. Now, you might think the simplest thing to do would be just to wrap on the end of this threaded bolt, and you could do that, but the problem is that this whole ear can break, and then you're hooped, you're really in trouble. And so what we're going to do today, I've got an inch and a 16th socket, I'm going to put it over here, I'm going to put the whole thing in the vise, and I'm going to just push this mounting bushing back about a millimeter to give myself more room so there's some slop. So when I put it into place, it's a little easier. There. Now that the old pump is off the vehicle, let's have a closer look. It spins fine. But if you tip the pulley off axis, listen to this. Do you hear that clicking sound? That's the same kind of test used for wheel bearings. You tip the wheel off axis to look for any movement. That's all it took to make that loud clacking sound. In this design, the impeller has a very tight fit inside the housing. There are no witness marks on the blades, but I wonder if it was making sidewall contact. It may not come through in the video, but this water pump is annoying to do. You need to get at these two back bolts, and you'll never see them, and it has to be done entirely by feel. There's very little room. A regular socket is too short, and a deep socket is too long, and so I came up with this. This is an inch and a half extension, so the total length is 2 1/4 from end to end here. So the reassembly is the reverse of what you already saw, so I didn't record it. That knocking sound is completely gone, and the engine's fine. Now don't forget the last step. You can definitely ruin an engine if you fail to burp it of trapped air. Run the engine with radiator cap off until it warms up, the fans come on, and the thermostat opens. It takes about 20 minutes. If at any point the engine looks like it's overheating, turn it off and let it cool down. A spill-free funnel like this makes the task a lot easier and less messy. Recheck your reservoir levels in a few days and you're done. Say, I want to thank you for watching. I hope this helps out with your repairs.